Welcome back to Ball Diamond Live on WCRH-TV. I'm Andy Nelson along with Jeff Mullins. We're getting ready to start game two here. Chris Cabay will be taking the hill for the Cardinals. Let's get to that as soon as possible.
We're almost ready to get things started here from Ball Diamond. The lineups, let's see if we have those. If we don't, I can tell them to you right now. For Michigan State, it's going to be pretty much the same lineup. One change and a couple position changes. Carlos Fernandez is going to lead things off. Mike Pisani is going to play third base, played left field in the first game. Wagner, Kalzinski, Gesswine, Hartley, and Zigo staying at the same positions. McQuiston will play for Wachowski in left field, and Cruz is the shortstop, and on the hill for Michigan State will be Josh Axelson. For Ball State, it's going to be the same lineup, and we're ready to go with the first pitch here. It has been thrown in by Chris Cabay. Chris, of course, standing at 6 feet 10 inches tall.
And the first pitch was a strike. How about strike two? Chris Cabay off to a really good start. Carlos Fernandez stepping in. That one's outside to make it a 1-2 count here early on in game two. Of course, the Cardinals beat Michigan State in game one, 6-3. There's the next pitch was low and outside. That's going to make it 2-2. We're back underway here. We just had enough time to scarf down a couple of hot dogs. We're back in the action.
Thanks to Carter's for that lunch break.
Carter's nearly world famous hot dogs. Don't forget it's in the Village. The footlong special on Monday and Tuesday. So if you're down there at the den or something and maybe just in that neck of the woods, stop on in and see Carter. He will give you nearly world famous hot dogs.
So full count here.
Of course, for a price.
To start off the game.
There's a drive into right field. Bigby's going to take a little shade back and brings that one down. And that'll be one away. That'll bring up Mike Pisani, who is playing third in this game.
Playing third, yes. Played left in the first game, went 1-4, scored one of the 3 runs that Michigan State did have in that game. And Pisani will step to the plate now and try to make some things happen early on for Michigan State. You know, they got down early in the first game and were never able to recover, so I'm sure that Coach Ted Mahan told them during this break, hey, let's jump out on Ball State. And it's going to be tough to do with Cabay out there on
right
the hill.
Right call there on Pisani. 1-1 the count. One out. Top of the first in game two here. Half swing. He's going to check with the other umpire. No, he's just going to go ahead and call the strike himself. 1-2. Fouls that one back into the cage. Still 1-2.
Of course, the only real change in the Michigan State batting lineup will be the addition of McQuiston, Chris McQuiston. He will play in left field, and Pisani here is playing third
base.
There's
a drive, and we automatically look out, folks. More cars attempted to be destroyed. However, still 1-2. The pitch to Pisani. That's popped straight up in the air.
The new catcher for Ball State, Tim Fitzharris, who played third and was our Carter's nearly world-famous player of the game. He's behind the plate. John Kesick will be in the game. He will DH for the Cardinals. We'll get you that lineup here when the Cardinals come to the plate in the bottom of the first inning. So Chris Cabay, as we said earlier, was roughed up in his last outing against Indiana State last Tuesday. So hopefully Chris is fresh and ready to go today. He looks pretty good.
Outside ball two.
2-2 the count on Pisani.
Ground ball down, and it just gets in between Jeremy Ridley and Matt Wood, and Bigby's going to have to take that one. So Michigan State hit. Picks up a base hit. This one goes to Pisani.
So it took Michigan State nearly 4 innings to get a hit last game. And now Pisani starts off in the first inning with a base hit for the Spartans, who they have got to get things started early. That's been their problem in the first 2 games of this series. They have gotten down. Yesterday it was big 8-1, and today it was it was just 3-1, but they were never able to cut that lead. They were able to cut the lead to 3-2 at one point, but the Ball State responded. So definitely need to jump out on Ball State here, and that's a tough thing to do.
That'll bring up Mike Wagner, center fielder, wearing number 23.
Mike. Go, go, go!
That pitch gets behind Viteris, and Pisani will make it all the way to second, uncontested.
Mike was 0 of 3 in game 1, and...
Want to know the count to Wagner. Pitch on the way. Drive into right field. Bigby and Bava are going after it. Bigby's going to handle this one way at the warning track.
He's going to tag.
Yep, and he'll get in safely to third base. So runner already in scoring position for Michigan State with two outs. That'll bring up their big man.
Deep drive there by Wagner. Cabe throws hard, so extra jump off the bat there for the hitters. But
Kalsinski now stepping in. Cabe steps out the rubber and comes back. Did you see the replay there? Pitch on the way. Kalsinski takes a strike.
Cabe, an intimidating pitcher out there. I mean, he stands at 6 feet 10 inches tall, and he's the tallest pitcher in college baseball. And comparing to the big unit of Randy Johnson.
Fouls that one back, making it 1-1. It's kind of a nice afternoon here for baseball.
Kalsinski's
warmed up a little bit.
Yeah, it's probably around the 50-degree mark right now.
Fouled that one off of Fitzharris's mask, I believe. That might have jarred a couple of screws loose in the mask, of course.
Kalsinski scored two runs in the opener of this doubleheader. He had one hit. He was also hit by a pitch in that game, and I believe he walked once. But Kalsinski, the cleanup hitter, with a runner at third here with two outs. So...
They sit up the middle, and Michigan State's going to get on the board first. Kalsinski comes through, and Pisani will come around and score. So Michigan State jumps out of the early 1-0 lead.
So exactly what Coach Ted Mahan wanted to see. He's got the early lead on Ball State, and Chris Cabe coming off that performance against Indiana State on last Tuesday where he gave up 10 hits and 7 runs in just 2 1/3 innings. That's coming off an 8-inning shutout performance he did at Duke. So... Cabe, this is a big game for Cabe, because before that Duke game, he had been shelled as well in North Carolina. So this is a big game for Cabe, and hopefully he can shake off the first inning here.
That one's outside. 1-1 to count to Kyle Geschwin, the first baseman.
There's been kind of talk around that Cabe has lost, for some reason, 5 miles an hour on his fastball, and they don't know why. There's no injury. Just that last game against Indiana State, Cabe was, they noticed, Maloney and the pitching coaches noticed that he had lost 5 miles an hour on his fastball, so definitely something to be concerned about today. Cabe, I mean, we don't have a radar gun up here, but he looks like he's throwing the ball pretty hard today.
1-2 the count to Geschwin, swing and a foul ball. Still 1-2, two outs, runner on first. And already Michigan State has jumped out to the early 1-0 lead on two hits. Strike three called, and that'll be the end of the inning.
One run on two hits for Michigan State. And after one half inning of play, they lead it 1-0. And that'll give us a chance to hopefully look at the Ball State University starting lineup as we head into the bottom of the first. Leading it off for Ball State is going to be Scott French playing left field still. Tim Fitzharris is going to play. He's the catcher right now. He's going to bat in the second slot. And Bigby in right field will be your number three hitter. And followed by Ridley, of course, in the cleanup. Kesick will be the DH in this game. As there you see the lineup. Shad Turner at third base. Matt Wood is playing first base again in this one. And the same two hitters to end the lineup for the Cardinals, Jane Ridley at short and Eric Bava in center field. Andy, you have the Michigan State defense.
Michigan State defense at this time. We've got Geshwin at first base. Carlos Fernandez at second. Kevin Cruz at shortstop. Dasani is going to be playing third in this game. He played left, of course, in the last contest. Chris McQuiston, who came and pinch hit towards the end of game one, will now move out in left field where Pisani was before. Mike Wagner will remain in center. Tom Hartley will remain in right field. Kalsinski will be the catcher once again. And Scott Brandel will actually be replaced in this game by Josh Axelson.
And the numbers on Josh Axelson, the pitcher for the Michigan State Spartans. We've got those numbers here, and here they are for Michigan State. As we said, Josh Axelson, he's a sophomore. Axelson comes in with a lofty ERA of 11.25. He's 0-2 on the season. This is his fourth appearance and his fourth start. He has only pitched 12 innings, gonna have 18 hits, 18 runs, 15 earned. He's walked 6, struck out 11. He's given up 3 home runs and 5 other extra base hits. So
strike 1-2, Scott French.
So one run is probably not going to be enough to support Mr. Axelson, and with Ball State's offense, surely
two.
Ted Mahan has got to be concerned. Hopes that his young sophomore has come to pitch a great game here in game two. It's a high out of play. Actually, it's going to be caught over there
by Pisani.
Can't speak. I spoke too soon there.
That'll bring up Tim Fitzharris, who's catching this game. Of course, played third in the last contest. Giving Kesick a little time off behind the plate and just letting him swing the bat today.
Nice play there by Mike Pisani, you know, switching from left to
third
base.
There you see it right there. Look at that. Nearly ran into the fence.
So one gone here in the first for the Cardinals.
Fitzharris line drive. Whoa, nice attempt there by Kevin Cruz to get that one. Fitzharris rounds first, and he gets the first hit for the Cardinals in this contest, and that'll bring up the big man, Larry Bigby.
Nice piece of hitting there by Mr. Fitzharris. He was our player of the game last game, and he's off to a good start here. Bumped his average up to 375 in that last game with his 21st hit of the season in 56 at-bats. That's going to bring up Mr. Bigby, who was quiet in that
first
game.
Very quiet in the first contest. Maybe he'll break out here.
One hit and one RBI and a run scored, and that was all done in the first inning. And we didn't hear much from Mr. Bigby after that. He lined out, popped out, and he did reach on an error on that. He hit that one to deep center, which scored a run, but a quiet game for Mr. Bigby.
There's a high fly ball to left field. McQuise is going to run over there and catch it pretty much near the line. Fitzharris will go back to first base.
So a lot of fly balls from Bigby tonight so far today. He had 3 hits in Friday's game and only 1 in the first one. So see what Jeremy Ridley can do. What was he in the first game? He was 1 of 2 with an RBI and a run scored. And I believe that Mr. Ridley was walked and he had a sacrifice fly that gave Ball State their final run of the game in game one.
Jeremy Ridley is going to be batting from the left side here. Of course, he's over 400. I don't know if that still applies even with last game. He fouls that one back to the cage.
Still batting 410, 25 of 61 on the season for Mr. Ridley. And Ball State, some lofty averages in there. They stuck pretty much what they were when we started today's play in game one there. Just a really good win in that first game, 6-3. As Maloney said after the game, they played good situational baseball, and we saw that with, you know, some timely sacrifice flies, some sacrifice bunts to move runners over. Just the things you got to do to win baseball games, and when you're a good baseball team like Ball State, you can do that.
Whoa, way inside on Jeremy Ridley. He got out of the way. 1-1 the count now. 2 outs, runner on first. That's Tim Fitzharris. Ball State trailing this one early, 1-0.
But as we said, Josh Axelson, he's got a lofty ERA, so one run is probably not going to be the decisive run in this game. Ball State with the early base runner there, so we'll see what we can get done here.
Long drive into right field.
That's
way deep and way gone. It's a home run time, and the crowd is on their feet for Jeremy Ridley, who just gives Ball State the lead with a home run. First one we've seen all day, and man, that was exciting.
A home run.
Jeremy Ridley.
Jeremy Ridley. That's going to get the fans up here early. As I said, Josh Axelson, that's his fifth home run of the season. He's given up, and for Jeremy Ridley, he now ties the team lead. He's got four home runs now, I believe. Yeah, that ties him. Actually, he's going to take the lead, excuse me. That's the fifth home run of the season for Jeremy Ridley, and the 25th home run for the Cardinals this year. That is unbelievable if you think about that. 25 home runs so far, and Ball State is playing their 14th game. We're almost at a two per game average.
First pitch to John Keswick was a ball. And that one's going to be a ball as well. So 2-0 the count to John Keswick. Pitch down the middle. Fooled Keswick a little bit. He swung at it. 2-1 the count now. That one's low and away, making it 3-1. So Ball State could possibly get another runner on if ball four was to come across the plate. Actually, it wouldn't come across the plate. It'd come outside of the plate.
Very easy.
Hence the definition of the word ball. There's a foul ball.
You sell yourself short there, Nelson.
Keswick, of course, you might remember, took that big pitch into the head in the last game. Kind of scared us all for a little bit. He just ran over to first like nothing happened. These baseball guys are tough.
In the nightcap off here, the DH.
Half swing, no appeal on that, so Keswick will get a free pass to first base. And that'll bring up Shad Turner, who's moving into the third base position for this game. Of course, basically, was the DH in the last game. It's just a big switch of the same players, basically.
It's given your catcher, John Keske, caught Friday's game and caught the first one here. So, catching's got to be a little tough on the knees, just resting him a little bit. But you need his big bat in the lineup, and that keeps this lineup solid. Really solid lineup here for Ball State, and so far,
strike one automatically to Shad Turner. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. He was a little bit ahead of that one.
Shad's 12 of 28 on the season. He, in game one, Shad went 1 of 3 with an RBI, and as you see, he is batting .400.
That one's low and away.
Over .420 on the season, with 12 hits this season. So Chad's gonna have to work the count here with a 1-2.
I thought that might have curved in and actually got into the zone. But
that looked like it was a little high.
2-2 the count to Shad Turner. Keswick over on first base.
Not a big lead there from Keswick.
Nope. We've already seen how good Kalsinski's arm is, as no stolen bases have been successful for either team in this game. Maybe they'll try to run on Fitzharris in this one.
It's a possibility. You do lose Keswick's arm when he's not behind the plate, but we've still got his bat in. So I'm sure Ted Maha knows. Terrace is behind the plate, and he'll probably try to test it.
Keswick taking a generous lead at first. He's going. Hit and run is on. Cruz has trouble with it, but he gets the ball over to first base. I thought Gesher might have stepped off the bag before he caught the ball.
So 6-3 to end the inning for the Cardinals. The big blast by Jeremy Ridley gives Ball State a two-run lead. Two runs, two hits, no errors. And after one inning of play, Ball State leads it 2-1 here in game two. This is Ball State University Baseball.
back on Ball State Baseball, and Chris Cabay pitches a ball for the first pitch here to...
That would be...
That's Tom Hartley.
Tom Hartley, number 24.
What out of the Michigan State dugout.
Gary Zigo. Zigo is lucky to have his head right there. Wow. I'm telling you what, there is not a lot of space between
the dugouts,
the warm-up.
And there's not a lot of, you know, blocking stuff. I mean, you got to be heads up, and it's a wrong thing to say in that situation. Somebody almost lost their head. By the way, there's a ground ball, and Tom Hartley is out.
I mean, with where they warm up and the way these balls come off these aluminum bats, man.
Yeah.
But anyway, Hartley grounds out to the pitcher, so all is well here at Ball Diamond. So that'll bring up
Gary Zigo.
Mentioned Gary Zigo. I think is it Zigo, Zigo? Let's go with Zigo.
Well, we're probably never going to have a chance to ask him, so we'll just stick with Zigo. Stick with what works.
Zigo went hitless in game one. Did have a sacrifice fly, I believe. That a fielder's choice that scored a run.
Strike right down the middle
for Michigan State in game one.
1-1, the count to Zigo.
So Cabay, you know, he's looking pretty good out there. He's got pretty good control today.
Pop up. That one's going to be foul. I don't think anybody can get to that one as it lands over in the batting cage bullpen area thing off near right field.
It'd be Michigan State bullpen just to identify things. Once again, we're at Ball Diamond here in Muncie, Indiana. Beautiful Ball Diamond. Really nice facility out here. And it looks great to be on
pitch
TV.
From Cabay. There's a fly ball in right field.
Right to Bigby.
Bigby, he's got it.
They'll put out to Larry Bigby. So Chris Cabay, after that rocky start, has retired the last three batters. That'll bring up the only addition, the number 8 slot. As there you saw Cabay's number so far this season. That'll bring up McQuiston, Chris McQuiston. He, of course, pinch hit and walked in the top of the ninth in the game one, but McQuiston takes one outside right there.
Second pitch on the way from Cabay. That one's outside as well, making it 2-0, rather, in the hitter's favor, in this case, McQuiston. Pitch number 3. Weiston will look at another ball, and this one makes it 3-0. So two outs.
Not what you like to see there. McQuiston only batting 100 on the season, so I want to give him, I'm going to put somebody on base that really hasn't shown they can be much of a threat at the plate, but
he just went ahead and did that with ball 4. As now we move on to Carlos Fernandez, the leadoff hitter, second baseman.
The correct year right there, that'll be Cruz coming on.
You're right. My bad.
Kevin Cruz, the freshman from Hinkley, Ohio, playing shortstop again here in game number 2.
Yes, he is the shortstop.
Strike. Popping the mitt there, wow.
Yeah.
Cabay throwing the heat there. Hopefully, maybe he's retained that 5 miles an hour he lost in Indiana State off his fastball.
I hope Fitzharris is wearing some earplugs. That'd probably break your eardrums.
That was just kind of the word going around here. Just talking to Bob Moore.
Wow, quick pickoff move by Cabay over to first.
I was talking to Bob Moore yesterday about, and he mentioned that it was just kind of they didn't understand why Cabay had lost, 5 miles an hour for the fastball. So.
Inside, 1-1. Or actually, they called it a strike, didn't they? How about 0-2?
But it still looks like a pretty fast ball to me.
Sure does. Probably tough to judge ball or strike. It comes in so fast. Try to get him on the outside corner. Didn't bite.
This one just scheduled for 7 innings, the nightcap of the doubleheader, although it's still daytime.
Technically, I guess the afternoon cap. Whoa.
Ooh, inside. Normally, doubleheaders are played when the MAC play comes in. Both games will be 7 innings, but today's game was moved ahead because it was scheduled. This game was scheduled to happen on Sunday, but the possibility of inclement weather tomorrow moved it. There's a
ground ball to Jeremy Ridley. He's just going to go over to first for the third out. And he'll retire the side as we prepare for the Ball State Cardinals to come up in the bottom of the first.
So no runs.
Actually, it would be the bottom of the second.
bottom of the second, no runs, no hits, a walk, and a man was left running, I guess you could say.
Mm-hmm.
And after an inning and a half, Ball State leads it 2-1, still on that Ridley home run. Once again, just gives me a chance to promote Campus News 57. Don't miss Campus News 57, Monday through Thursday at 5:30 and 6 o'clock, plus the news at noon on Tuesday and Thursday. Get all of the latest Ball State news and sports. Find out what's happening in your hometown and your Muncie five-day weather forecast. That's Campus News 57, where Ball State comes first. So in the bottom of the second, we're going to have Matt Wood, Shane Ridley,
and Eric Bava.
Eric Bava. See, it's easy to get those Ridleys confused.
Yes.
Being the twin brothers that they are. And let's just take a look at their statistics from game one. And how was what it looked like in game one? Well, it looked like this. Shane Ridley was 2-of-4 in game one, playing shortstop. And Eric Bava was 1-of-3, but we'll tell you that when he comes to the plate.
As Matt Wood steps in to be the first hitter here in the bottom of the second.
Matt went hitless but had two RBIs in game one.
First pitch to Wood. Inside.
Matt probably would like to get a base hit today.
That one way inside, almost caught him in the knee. How about 1-1? I thought it was 2-0. First pitch was a strike.
Apparently so.
I didn't even hear him call it. And I'm looking right at him. Okay.
Thinking that would be...
strike two, because he actually swung and missed that one.
Mike Walsh behind the plate and Tom Kavasic right down the right field line currently.
Ground ball right at Geschwin. He makes a nice little play on a chopper, throws it over to Axelson. That's the play they always practice in spring training, you know, like 100 times.
Nice play.
Axelson running over and covering first.
That's his job, to run over there, cover first. Otherwise, you know, there's no chance to get an out. So nice play there by Axelson. Good fundamental baseball by the Spartans.
Yep, and that'll bring up Shane Ridley here, the shortstop. Maybe he can do what his brother did and hit a home run.
There's the play right there, as you see Axelson.
There's a drive into left field that's going to be maybe a little short. McQuiston moves over. He's got it. So two outs in the bottom of the second, and that'll bring up the center fielder and number 9 hitter, Eric Bava.
Bava went 1-of-3 in game one and scored one of the Ball State runs. He's batting .400 this season. Has one home run. Of course, he's one of 11 players to hit home runs for this Cardinal team. And as we saw, Jeremy Ridley added to the – he was already on that list. But
strike called on the inside corner. 1-1 the count to Eric Bava.
Ridley gave us that 2-1 lead with the shot in the first inning.
Just outside. And
Michigan State contingent.
Fans didn't really like that.
Quite a few Michigan State fans on hand. I see a lot of green over there.
Yeah, they just wearing the shirts they wore for St. Patrick's Day.
You're still in a haze from St. Patrick's Day. That's pretty rough.
Yeah. Tomorrow is laundry day, I guess. All right.
Bava walks.
Yes, he does. And Ball State has a man on first base in Eric Bava, bringing up to the top of the order. And that'll bring up left fielder Scott French.
Scotty popped out to third base to start the bottom half of the first, so French bats here in the second. And the Cardinals with the base runner on and chances to just add the lead. Of course, Ball State will be in action on We'll just stay right here with that one.
Uh-oh. Please don't hit the truck.
Ooh.
Okay.
I think everybody's okay back there.
Thank you. Throw to first. Wow, what a great pickoff move.
Bava diving back in there head first. Get the uniform dirty early. That's what you like to see.
Axelson throws to the plate. Ball there as well. We're looking at 1-1 here. 2 outs in the bottom of the second inning. Ball State up 2-1. Scott French at the plate. Eric Bava on first. That one's way inside. They try on Kalsinski again, and still no stolen bases.
Thought we would have learned by the first inning. So French will come to the plate for Ball State when they bat in the bottom of the third, but no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left. So at the end of two innings of play, Ball State leads it 2-1. You're watching Ball State Cardinal Baseball.
Hey, where you been? Come on, come on! Where in the world would you find a top 10 teacher's college? Ball State University. And where can you find one of the nation's highest student-athlete graduation rates? Ball State! Now that's higher education. And guess who has Indiana's largest undergraduate programs in theater and dance performance? Put on your dancing shoes.
Ball State University, everything you need.
I'm Andy Nelson along with Jeff Mullins. We're getting ready for the top of the third inning. Let's take a look at this throw by Kalsinski. Once again, nobody has stolen a base in either game today. They have been thrown out. Look at that. Crew's just waiting.
Yeah, you don't want to, looks like you don't want to try Joe Kaczynski, Kalsinski, not to be confused with Ted there.
Yep.
Kalsinski, get that right. Don't want to implicate him in anything.
There's a foul ball. Watch out, truck. Okay.
It will be the top of the order for Michigan State here.
Starting with Carlos Fernandez.
Coming up between innings, our Eric Bastien is going to talk to game one starter Justin Weschler. Look forward to that.
Ooh, swing and a miss. 0-2 the count to Carlos Fernandez here early in the third inning. The 0-2 pitch. Strike three called.
Sit down.
Wow. Cabe gets him looking, and that's Cabe's first strikeout of the game, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's his second.
Yeah, you always learn, and you learn early that you got an 0-2 count. Probably not a good time to take a pitch. It looks pretty close. That one looked to be right down the middle.
And that'll bring up Mike Pisani. Looks
squared
bunt.
A bunt. Guess he brought the bat back right there. The sun has went down here at Ball Diamond.
Got a really good hold of that one as it goes deep to left field, and foul would have been a home run had it stayed fair. Really turned on that pitch, pulled the ball to left field.
Obviously, Cabe took a little something off that, and that's exactly what the hitter Pisani looked for. He was maybe looking for the breaking pitch, and he turned on it. That's why he was so out in front of it, I would say.
Yeah.
So, Cabe looks good so far.
1-1 the count of Pisani. He doesn't get as much wood or, I guess, aluminum on this one. It's just kind of a little bloop pop-up into right field. Bigby will have no trouble with that. Two away.
Bat number 23, Mike Wagner.
That'll bring up Mike Wagner.
Flied to Bigby in the first inning. And that sent Pisani as he tagged on that fly ball. And then Kalsinski's single, of course, scored Pisani to get the Michigan State Spartans on the board in game one, or game two.
Pitch from Cabe. Strike
nice
ball.
Nice curveball. Nice little curveball there by Chris. Got full command about just about every pitch today.
Strike two called to Mike Wagner.
Wagner is 0-1 today.
So Cabe could end this one with another punch out. If he does the right thing here, let's see what happens. Nope, got a bat on that one. Ridley's right there for the line drive. And that'll be the end of the Michigan Spartans' third inning.
No runs, no hits. Nobody left on base because nobody reached base. And after 2.5 innings, Ball State leads the guests, the Michigan State Spartans, 2-1. Right now, we're going to go down to our Eric Bastien, who is with a happy pitcher, Justin Weschler, from game one. Eric, take it away.
Thanks, guys. I'm joined by Game 1 winner Justin Weschler, who ran his record to now 1-1 on the young season. Justin, your first outing here at Ball Diamond. What do you think of the surroundings here?
I really like it here, and playing for a good team, and I was just trying to throw strikes.
What'd you do out there that was good today?
I competed. I battled. When I didn't have my best stuff, but I got the win, so.
They got timely hits for you. I'm sorry, your record is 3-1. I'm sorry. Good start for your freshman year, Justin.
Yeah, I'm just hoping I keep it up. So.
Looking forward to many more. We'll send it back up to you guys.
All right, thanks a lot, Eric.
Very soft-spoken young freshman there. Probably, he's got to be really happy. Probably the nerves were, probably last night when he went to bed, he was thinking, hey, it's my first start for the college that came after me and recruited me, and I came here, and it's now my first start. Yeah. New Diamond. Nice outing for him. He did go 5 1/3, 3 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned. He walked 4, struck out 3, and I think he was exactly right. He battled, and that was the important thing in game one there. It was a game where he had to battle. And leading it off for Ball State in the third inning
is Scott French, because if you remember correctly, he was up in the last inning when Bava tried to steal and was caught.
And as Kelczynski's been saying all day, I don't think so. Don't try my arm. So we'll see what happens.
First pitch to French. Bunted down the third base line. Kind of surprised third baseman, but it rolls foul.
Good idea there. Your leadoff man, got to be one of your best runners, and he would have beat that out if that ball stayed fair.
That's
no
correct.
No question about that. As we don't have, that Ball State doesn't have the dirt right down the sidelines there, so it's going to die in that grass.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very nice idea there, but the third baseman is now moved in towards the bag, so I doubt French will be bunting here.
Another bunt. This one's
bunt,
a pop up, and nobody catches it.
Shows you how much I know. Scott was 1-4 in the first game today. Today he's so far in game two, he's 0-1 for the Cardinals.
The 0-2 pitch to French. Inside. Ball one. Strike three called to Scott French, and he'll take a seat and get ready to go play left field.
Yes, he will.
That'll bring up Tim Fitzharris again, who is behind the plate in this one. Was, of course, our Carter's nearly world-famous player of the game.
Don't know who we're taking a look at there. The fans enjoying the nice, serene afternoon here at Ball Diamond.
Serene, excellent word.
I like that word. I like it, too. It's real calm now, It's the planes going on overhead, and just a beautiful afternoon for baseball, if I can say so myself. Nice, beautiful pitch there by
Fitzharris has taken
Josh
two called strikes.
That was a nice curveball there. That caught the outside corner of the plate, and Fitzharris has got to protect now.
Time called for some reason. I guess because Axelson stood off of the rubber. But he's back now, and the game will continue. Pitch on the way, 0-2. Way inside. Did it catch a piece of him? It did.
Took him, yeah.
Free base. Man, a lot of hit batsmen today.
The left arm, it's a young season right now, and pitcher's just grabbing control. And Terrace looks to be okay. It looks like he took that one off the left elbow.
Yeah.
Looks like it might have hit him up in the where did that hit? Top. Well, I guess it caught him
maybe
in the ribs.
Yeah, that would hurt. Bigby, he pops one way up and foul. That's somewhere on the galliard.
Actually, it's over on the practice field. Yeah, quite a shot out there to McGalliard.
The 0-1 to Bigby. Inside. 1-1.
Larry, I guess you could say a little mini slump,
Mini slump, yeah.
Mini slump. He hasn't had a hit in 4 at-bats.
Here's the pitch. A little high to Larry. 2-1. Axelson may be afraid to pitch to Bigby and maybe even more afraid once Jeremy Ridley steps into the plate, knowing what he did to him the last time.
This is probably a good opportunity for Biggie to make him pay.
Biggie just takes one deep to right field. No chance. Look up. Cars in the football stadium. Jeez.
Larry Bigby. That's his fifth home run. He retakes the lead for the team in home runs. He takes the lead over his teammate. And next up to the plate, Mr. Jeremy Ridley. So the fifth home run on the season for Larry. And the 26th home run for the Ball State Cardinals so far this year. That is almost, if it'll be today's the 14th, or this game two is the 14th game, with 25 home runs, we're nearing the two-game average.
That's why I like Axelson. I mean, he's given us the nice pitches. We're pleasing the fans here on a nice Saturday afternoon. This is the first home game, correct?
Yes.
And the fans come out. They want to see some home runs. Bigby delivers. Jeremy delivers. Unfortunately, they had to wait till game two, which we've been doing this all day. Been great.
Well, the Cardinals hit two home runs yesterday in the opener.
Jeremy wanted that pitch, I think, but he'll hang off. And it is 0-1.
Yesterday, Jeremy's brother Shane hit a home run, and also Matt Deckman, a pinch hitter. We haven't seen him yet today, but one pitch, and he hit a home run.
Bunt right to Axelson. Throws to first. That's it. Deckman almost had trouble with that one.
So Larry Bigby's home run. Let me get that one marked away.
Yep. Now here we go to replay of the home run. Let's take a look at that again. Look how fast he swings this bat. Of course, it'll be in slow motion on a replay, but just look at the swing. Got out in front of the ball and just see you
smoked
later.
It.
He knew it
no
as
doubt
soon
about
as he hit
that
it.
One. No doubt. Estimated how far did it fly, Nelson?
600 feet.
600 feet. 1 kilometer on that one.
It might still be going. I don't know. John Kesick stepping in. Cardinals take a 4-1 lead off the homer by Bigby, and that's a way to get some runs on the board quick. Hey, have a couple guys on, hit a home run. That's the way it should be.
That's how it's went so far for Ball State.
That's right.
Get a base runner and then crank a home run. So,
bottom of the third, two outs. The 0-1 pitch to Kesick. He'll take it, and it's a ball.
It's what you like. It's what you like to see if you're Rich Maloney over there. You win game one, or you start out game one, you play good situational baseball, and now you're just letting the power just, you're just smoking right now. You got two home runs in three innings of play. So,
the 1-1 is low.
Yeah, we're getting word from our estimate. We're going to estimate about 400 feet on that one, Andy. I think you're 600 is a lot.
Is that the Southwest Airlines? How far did it fly?
No, we don't get those kind of sponsors here yet, but we like what we see right now. And
yeah, our sponsor would be like paper airplanes. How far did it fly?
We've got Carter's, though.
Yeah, Carter's.
So we'll stick here. Actually, we're going to, after two runs, two hits in that inning, Ball State leads it 4-1. This is Ball State University Baseball.
When something happens, Campus News 57 is there.
Sunday morning, approximately around 7 a.m., a fire broke out in the officers' room located on the second floor. We really need blood donors, and we want more people to sign up for the National Marrow Donor Program, too.
Housing Residence Life may have to house some students in study lounges, and some RAs may have roommates.
Campus News 57, where Ball State comes first.
Are your grades in the dumps, your love life in the pits, your morale in the doldrums? Well, a couple of drinks may not solve your problems, but they'll sure help you forget about them for a while, right? Alcohol won't help your love life, your grades, or your morale. It'll only make things worse. If you're trying to solve a problem, why not try a counselor or a friend instead of the bottle?
All right, welcome back to Ball Diamond. Andy Nelson along with Jeff Mullins. Ball State Cardinals have an early 4-1 lead thanks to a couple of homers, one by Jeremy Ridley and a big monstrous bang by Larry Bigby here in the bottom of the third. We move to the top of the fourth. Cabay will throw a strike to Steve Kalsinski. Check swing foul down the first baseline.
Kalsinski singled and was stranded in the first inning of play for Spartans. Kalsinski homered on Friday.
The 0-2 to Kalsinski. Way over his head. Gutierrez loses his mask going up after that one. But everybody is calm now, and it's 1-2.
Keep the viewers at home calm there, Mr. Nelson.
The 1-2 pitch. Outside, called, strike three.
Go ahead,
that'll
have a seat there, Mr.
Cousins. Fourth
Cousins
of the game or his fifth? I believe that is his.
That is his third strike.
How about his third? Apparently, I can't count the number of Ks on our little score sheet up here.
Thought I was doing a better job of keeping score here in this second game, but yeah, that's the third strikeout for Mr. Cabe, and telling you what, that was a nasty pitch right there.
Yep, that'll bring up first baseman Kyle Geswin.
Geswin was one of those three strikeout victims in the first inning for the Spartans.
Ground ball right hard at Cabe. It's not like you're going to hit a ball over his head. He is 6'10". I would have had to jump for that ball and still not gotten it.
That was bad. The right fielder, Tom Hartley.
Yeah, I mean, you just look at him right there in the shot. I mean, he just towers over everybody.
You can't even see, like, the center fielder. Check this out. He doesn't even have to jump. Just kind of hits, you know, belt level to him, which, of course, yeah, see? Look at that.
But
that was at least 7-8 feet in the air. Jordan couldn't have got that. Michael Jordan. Former baseball player himself. The pitch on the way from Cabe, swing and a miss.
You can stay that way.
1-1 the count to Tom Hartley.
Cabe works fast too. I know we commented earlier that Wechsler liked to work pretty fast, but Cabe, he's ready to rock and roll. And that guy, you know, Hartley stepped out of the play there, but
took something off of that one, but low and outside. 2-1 the count now to Tom Hartley. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss, strike two. Count is even. And deuces are wild once again here at Ball Diamond. Two balls, two strikes, two outs.
Well,
except
we're
in the fourth inning, so technically that's not a deuce. But okay.
These guys aren't really touching Cabe right now. And time was called there. Cabe's ready. He's ready to go. He's eyeing in that. He's eyeing that mitt right now. He wants to get it right here.
Ground ball, Shane Ridley's got this one, throws it over to first, and that'll do it for the top of the fourth inning. So we're just cruising through this game.
Quick one, no runs, no hits.
Halfway through the game right now.
And Ball State leads it 4-1 after 3.5, and that just gives us time to thank our sponsor for our lunch between the games there, Carter's Hot Dogs. Carter's nearly world-famous hot dogs, of course. One time known to be outside of by Dill Street with a little stand outside. There's the play that ended the inning with Ridley's throw over to Matt Wood. And this game really cruising along. But Carter's, we thank him for that between games there. And located on Martin Street in the village right here in Muncie, of course. And Carter's, of course, started that business out on the street, you know, fooling with the cool weather like that, and decided to move it inside. And the restaurant, the business is going well, I think, for Mr. Carter. And it's when you have a footlong special like that, I think the business is definitely going to go right.
As long as I keep showing up there, I keep the guy in business for sure. Just on my own.
Yeah, he gets about $1.50 or $1.75 from me about every Thursday night. And now it's turning into Wednesday nights, too, so.
Yeah.
And Friday and Saturday every now and then, too. So leading off for the Cardinals here in the
bottom of the fourth. Hi, Mr. Umpire.
The umpire's waving at us. New pitcher in the lineup for
Dan Horvath.
Dan Horvath.
Or Horvath.
He's 2-0 this season. 3 strikeouts, only 7 innings pitched. And he does not have an ERA. No earned runs given up. He's only given up 3 hits in 7 innings of play. So, hey, this guy could shut us down.
Yep.
No home runs given up. Hopefully we haven't seen the last home
strike
run of the day.
Strike one, Shad Turner. How about strike two? Wow.
Hi.
Horvath not wasting
any
time.
How you doing, Mr. Horvath? Welcome.
Maybe that's who the umpire's waiting to. Outside, ball one.
Maybe he's just warning us. This guy throws heat. You better look out.
Yeah. Might want to shut that window. Swing and a miss, strike three. So Horvath takes really no time
at all
to get rid of a Ball State player.
First
and Shad Turner is his first victim. That'll bring up the first baseman, Matt Wood.
Matt grounded out to the first baseman in the second inning.
There's a drive into right field. Could this be home run number three? I don't know. I think it's going to go to the warning track. It could be. Yeah, it's in the gap.
It's the wall. Is he going to go for three?
Outfielder scrambling around. No, he's going to stay with two. Quite a throw out there in center field from Mike Wagner. So Matt Wood picks up a double, and we've got somebody in scoring position for Shane Ridley. Again, we're in the bottom of the fourth. Cardinals lead the game 4-1 on four hits. Michigan State with one run off of two hits. And if you've been joining us for this whole game, you have seen some fireworks from Jeremy Ridley and most recently, Larry Bigby.
Matt Wood's second double of the season for the Cardinals right there. Steps in Shane Ridley. Ridley flied out the left his first time up, and in game one, Ridley
going
was
inside.
I'm all over the place. Ridley was 2 of 4 in game one. The left-hander probably wants to equal what his brother did in the first inning.
Low and inside, ball one. 1-1 the count to Shane Ridley. One out as well. We've got Matt Wood on second base in scoring position. Cardinals just need to move him around. Ground ball to Carlos Hernandez. He'll make the play to first, but Matt Wood will advance to third. So a slight sacrifice, I guess.
That was that center fielder, Eric Bava.
That'll bring up the number 9 hitter, center fielder Eric Bava.
So he moves the runner over, and Bava's got a chance here. He walked his first time up.
That will go down as a sacrifice. Honestly, I think. I could be wrong.
Not sure on the official scoring on that. Marking it down as a 4-3.
Showed bunt.
Whoa,
they throw it back to third. Kalsitsky, don't mess with that arm.
Don't mess with that guy. You know, he's having a rough day, so.
He could throw out the flash.
Having a rough day at the plate, but he's having a nice game behind the plate.
One-oh pitch to Eric Bava. He swings. It bounces over. Chris Cabay would have had that one.
Off the
shortstop can't get it. Kevin Cruz has trouble. Ball State will score. As Matt Wood crosses the plate, it is now 5-1 Cardinals.
See what the ruling is there. I don't know. It appeared maybe it
they gave
hit
a hit
the bag.
On,
it was,
gave him a hit on that one.
Gave him a hit. I think it's a good call. I think it might have bounced off the bag or close enough to the bag where it could interfere. And you see the
Cardinals. I don't know if we can get a replay of that. I'd kind of like to see what happened, but.
Cardinals right there, enjoying the run scored by
Road
Matt
first.
Wood.
Bava gets back.
So Bava's base hit.
Scott
and,
French checks in.
For Mr. Bava, that is his third RBI of the season. And here's the top of the order.
High and wide.
Top of the order, French. Yes. Scott French. I knew it, Scott. Roll of two today is Scott.
He can't hear you, dude.
That's okay. He might have. The window's open here. Wild
pass
pitch.
Ball. And it looks like Eric Bava will round second. Maybe try for third. Nope. Just kind of
chilling.
Yeah, don't mess with Kalsinski. I think I could probably throw a ball to the teacher's college from here.
Go ahead. That'd probably score a run right now. That'd be nice. Yeah, two base air.
Yep. 2-0 to Scott French with a runner on second. So they could get maybe another run out of this. There are two outs, though. All it takes is maybe a one-base hit into the gap. And that might have done it.
There it is. Nice foreshadowing there, Mr. Nelson.
I like to segue into things that I can normally predict. No, I couldn't predict that. It was just a great hit right there by Scott French. Just hit the ball just over Cruz's head and allowed Bob to come around and score.
Fourth RBI on the season for Scott French.
Yep. 5-1 Cardinals, or is it 6-1?
No, 5-1
Cardinals. Sixth hit of the game. There you see Bava. That's the sixth run. Scoreboard's wrong. Yeah, it's 6-1. Good job. See, there's the base hit. No chance to get Bava, as he was already across the plate before the throw.
He's
really
quite
made
the speedster, the Eric Bava. Here's Tim Fitzharris. A bit of a two-out rally here for the Cardinals.
With two outs, he's going to be running on anything, so I had no chance to get him. But the runner did not make it to second, so French is at first. Mr. Fitzharris.
There's a little bloop. It's going to be a single into right field as that one will drop in just shy of the foul line.
Fitzharris took a big turn.
Maloney's right. Waving him in. No, he's going to put him on hold.
Maloney, let's see. I think he was. I think he was waving him in.
Bigby with another chance here. The crowd, asking Larry if he'd go ahead and please hit a home run. We'd like that. So.
Let's see what Bigby can do here. Yeah, we need another nice highlight reel for one of our open tapes or something. Come on, Larry. Help us out, buddy.
Two home runs so far for the Cardinals. Larry, we just take a base hit, too. Double, maybe triple. I don't care.
Oh, I'm telling you, that one's in Fort Wayne. Nope, just on the softball field.
Just east on I-69.
So 0-1. Runners on the corners for Larry Bigby. He could open this game wide open. Ground ball, second base. Carlos dives, can't get it. Maloney waving him in. No, he'll stop him. But Scott French comes around to score, and the merry-go-round of Ball State players continues as the score is now 7-1 here late in the fourth inning. This has been a two-out rally. They've scored three runs since getting two outs.
Well, for Larry Bigby, that's... That would be his, I believe, 13th RBI, 14th RBI for the season. And so Bigby, after we use the words mini slump, he drills one over the right field fence and then gets a ground ball into right field and has three RBI so far in this one.
Easily contending for the Carter's newly world famous player of the game, too.
Yes, probably about to, he has a lot of accolades and that'll just add to the list. Yep. Jeremy Ridley, one of two today.
Another base hit. We're going to get another run. It's 8-1 Cardinals. Are they going to send him? Yep. Maloney, no. See, he taunts us a little bit. He kind of teases us. Yeah, I'm going to bring him. No.
Well, I know.
But it is great to see the Cardinals out to an 8-1 lead right now, and Horvath is having a little bit of trouble on the mound. I'm surprised they don't have anybody up in the bullpen.
Yeah, I know when we
the guy's given up four runs here with two outs.
I know when we brought Horvath in, we joked that, we said... His ERA is 0.00, but right now his ERA is
600.
Rising as we speak. It's rising like the stock market. So
apparently soon it will be over 10,000. Is the stock market still over 10,000 today? Weekends, I don't really look at the paper, I guess.
Yeah. I believe that the stock market closed Friday just under 10,000, if I'm not mistaken.
Those NCAA tournament games should be on, aren't they?
Hey, when you got Bob Papper, you got to know the stock market.
That's right. Okay, that's a gapper.
Two runs will score.
I'm telling you, they can't stop us. If I were Ted, Mahan, I would maybe get somebody up in the bullpen. We do have somebody up in the bullpen now. But now is the game to please the Ball State faithful, as John Kesick just gets a two RBI single. Cardinals lead 10-1.
Late in the fourth. Six runs in the fourth already, and it's 10-1. You're right.
I guess they're just trying to make Michigan State remember us here in the last game of the series.
So
warming up in the Michigan State bullpen is Dominic Squires, who is listed on my sheet as a catcher. Hey, I guess they'll try anybody.
So now the same guy who started the inning, Mr. Chad Turner, will step in. And, Horvath is just getting hammered right now. It's just like batting practice up there for the Cardinals right now. I mean, that's what Rich Maloney tells me, guys. It's just me throwing up there, Let's go ahead and why don't you gap everything,
Chad Turner stepping in. That one's outside. Called strike. Every time I think it's outside, he's like, woo! So, hey, I got to go with what the ump says. Uh-oh. That one was nearly going to hit the bread truck, but we're okay.
We've heard a lot of uh-ohs from over there, Mr. Nelson.
Actually, that was actually not the bread truck. It was the Michigan State team bus.
That's okay, then.
Yeah, it's probably insured.
School pay for that.
There's a ball that gets away from Kalsinski and Kesick. Advance to second base.
Right now I have to use the fifth inning as part of my... I've got the wild pitch here by Horvath, and nothing going right for Michigan State right now.
Check this out. Here's a replay of Kesick's base hit. just kind of falls in the gap and far enough away that both the runners on second and third can score. Well-placed hit. Pitch to Shad. Ground ball right over the pitcher's head. Crew shouldn't be able to, you got that one. And he throws him out of first base.
So Turner makes two outs in the inning.
After four, with two outs, the fireworks explode here at Ball Diamond. We are leading this game 10-1. 10-1, six runs in the inning. We'll be right back with Ball State University Baseball.
The Total Lifestyle Center, located on the lower level of the Student Center, is Ball State University's fitness and wellness resource center. Our relaxed atmosphere and friendly staff offer a stress-free environment for you to address your wellness needs. Our fitness center offers a variety of cardiovascular and strength training equipment, plus locker room facilities. Appointments are available for free fitness assessments with our experienced fitness consultants, including blood pressure, body composition, muscular strength, and flexibility tests. A wide range of material is available in our Wellness Resource Center for personal and academic use. Our wellness fairs are offered once each semester. For more information, call the Total Lifestyle Center at 285-2744 or visit our website.
Welcome back to Ball Diamond Live Baseball on WCRH as the explosion that is Ball State Baseball continues here in Game 2. The Cardinals lead this one 10-1 as we head into the top of the fifth inning.
Six runs and six hits in that last inning to pretty much put this one away and make it the hit parade continued, or the hit parade just was on in that last inning with those six hits just consecutive.
Andy Nelson, Jeff Mullins with you. Gary Zego in the batter's box will step up against Chris Cabay, who's only given up two hits and one run in four innings here.
Shad Turner made two of the outs in that last inning. He batted twice. Started it with a strikeout and grounded out.
If Cabay's got his stuff, you think they'll keep him in for the whole game? I mean, it's only a seven-inning contest. Nobody's going to be available to get a save if the lead like this continues.
Well, it just depends if Rich Maloney would like to see Cabay, you know, gain confidence back after that shelling he took on Tuesday, or if he wants to get somebody from the bullpen an inning of work. I would say he'll probably go six the way he's going right now.
Swing and a miss there by Zego. The count is now at 1-2.
Zego flied out to right, and this is just his second at bat of the game.
Low and in the dirt. Fitzharris is right there on top of it. Not that anybody would be running anyways. Two-two, Scott him swinging. Another strikeout for Cabay. His
fourth of the game.
So
it's going to be a long bus ride back up to East Lansing. Get back there, maybe celebrate their basketball team's chances to the Final Four. See if that happens. But the baseball team's going to leave Muncie here 0-3.
Yep.
This one is all but said and done.
I just haven't seen anything out of Michigan State in the last 2 days that just tells me that this team can just come out of nowhere and, you know, just put runs on the board very quickly.
Yeah, they have been dominated a couple times this year. They were 8-3 when they came to Muncie, but lost a one game to Florida Atlantic, a team that's ranked in the top 25 in the ESPN USA Today poll, I believe number 22 this week. Florida Atlantic beat them 17-2, and they also lost to Louisiana Tech once this year, 17-0. So a couple of their wins have been against lesser schools, such as Pace, Lewis, and Iona. But they did beat Indiana State, however, 14-9. And, of course, we lost to Indiana State this past week, 13-9.
Strike two to McQuiston. So he had a 3-0, and he just threw two strikes in a row to McQuiston. So Cabay brings the count to full.
All that means nothing when Ball State plays here at Ball Diamond, 18-5 last year. And then
strike three strikes in a row. The bat did not even leave McQuiston's shoulder. He looked at three strikes in a row.
Well, obviously, Cabay has taken what happened in Terre Haute on Tuesday and just deleted that from his memory.
Yeah.
Now, coming up at between innings here, our Eric Basteen is going to visit with a former Ball State player last year, graduated shortstop Brian Dornan. And Mr. Bastien will have him between innings, hopefully. Yes, he will. And here's Kevin Cruz, 0-for-1 today.
1-1 they count to Cruz right now. Cabe has just been somewhat masterful today.
Cruz, he's hitless. He's hitless on the day, not just this game. He went 0-of-3. Did reach base, I believe, on a walk. He struck out. That's old news anyway.
Strike three.
Struck out the side.
Make it 6 strikeouts right now for Chris Cabe. And, yes, he struck out the side, which will bring the Ball State Cardinals back up to bat.
So no runs, no hits as no one hit the ball. And we're going to go down to Eric Bastien right now. He's got former Cardinal standout Brian Dorman. And we'll go down to Eric right now. Eric.
Thanks, guys. I'm joined by former Ball State player Brian Dorman, a 1997 team MVP to be exact, and started the most games of any Ball State player in history. Brian, what you been up to?
Not much. Just doing a little work right now, trying to get in shape for upcoming season.
And we heard you signed somewhere else. Where was I originally drafted by the Yankees, of course, in the amateur draft last fall, but where are you going to sign up at?
I'm playing in the Northern League in upstate New York with the Elmira Pioneers. So I've just been working out, get ready for that.
Sounds like a plan. So great career here at Ball State. Good luck to you, Brian. We'll send it back up to you guys.
Of course, thank you, Eric. Brian Dorman, one of the great shortstops, a long line of shortstops here at Ball State. And this year, of course, Shane Ridley has taken over at shortstop, and big shoes to fill there, and Shane has done pretty well this year. He's batting 322, and he'll hit next after Matt Wood here in this inning.
First pitch outside to Matt Wood. Bottom of the fifth here at Ball Diamond. Cardinals lead this game 10-1.
If you missed it last inning, fireworks, actually the third and the fourth for the Cardinals. Mr. Larry Bigby blasted a home run in the third, and then the Cardinals had a hit parade in the fourth to...
There's a pop fly into center field.
That's deep.
Pretty deep.
Pretty deep.
The warning track. I didn't think there was much on that one. It was probably just high enough.
And those balls will carry.
Wagner
here
takes
Ball
that
Diamond.
One. Yeah, Wagner takes that one down around the warning track.
So Wood flies out the deep center.
These batters are just teeing off the Michigan State pitchers here in game two. Every ball has been hit solid. Lee.
And Horvath still on the mound.
Yeah, ground ball here from Shane Ridley off the first pitch. Carlos Fernandez will take that and throw it over to Geschwin for out number two.
So this one in the books almost. I believe this is Eric Bava still up. It's going to be a pinch hitter. Mr. Aaron Zanel off the bench now.
Aaron Zanel is off the bench. First time we've seen him today.
First time we've seen him all weekend. Aaron has struggled a little bit. Aaron played... Of course, Aaron's a senior this year. Aaron's batting 233 on the year, 7-of-30. Has hit two home runs just as part of that powerful lineup. Zanel, he is not a senior. I said that he's a senior. He's a sophomore. He hit 7 home runs last year and plays left field, but kind of been in the pinch hitting role. There's also, he's been training to become a catcher, too. So Ball State's got a lot of catchers right now. We've also got Randy Ferris on the bench. And
strike called to Zanel.
And Doug Boone, also a redshirt freshman on. Ferris is a senior, Boone a redshirt freshman. And, of course, Viteris is catching today.
It's a pop-up.
In game two.
And it's going to be Kevin Cruz taking that one down. And that'll end the Ball State fifth inning. And...
No runs.
Ball State will take
the
field. No runs, no hits. 3 up, 3 down. And we'll be right back with Ball State University Baseball.
Motion picture production. Lights. Camera. Action. Big stars and even bigger budgets. In Wilmington, North Carolina, producers are leaving Tinseltown. Find out why big-time movies are taking their shows on the road and heading to your backyard, outside Hollywood.
Thursday, March 25th, on Campus News 57.
Well, I guess we're live back here at Ball Diamond. Andy Nelson along with Jeff Mullins.
New pitcher in the game. It'll be Adam Schieffel for the Cardinals. Also, Aaron Zanel will stay in the game. He just pinch hit and grounded out. He'll stay and play left field. And Scott French will move over from left field where he's been playing most of the day. And he'll anchor us out in center field. The new pitcher, Adam Schieffel. Schieffel comes in with a 4.82 ERA. No wins, no losses. This is his fourth appearance. He's actually started one game for the Cardinals. 9.1, actually. That's not 9.1. That's 9 1/3 innings pitched. He struck out 6, and he's given up 11 hits, 8 runs, 5 earned, and he has only walked 5. He has gave up one home run, and Schieffel's first pitch, Mr. Nelson, is a ball.
That is correct. That one was a strike, though, so it's 1-1 to Carlos Fernandez, the leadoff hitter in the batting order and in this inning.
Schieffel,
the top of the sixth. We are nearly probably an inning and a half away from being done.
Schieffel,
he's
had two relief appearances this
year.
That
one actually touched a car.
Did it? Did you hear it?
On a bounce, though.
Schieffel, two relief appearances since his first start. He started earlier this season. He was shelled in 5 1/3 innings at Butler. In the 11-10 Cardinals did win that game in 10 innings, 11-10. But Schieffel had a rough outing, so he's moved on to the bullpen. And people like guys like Weschler have stepped up. And Schieffel is probably one of those spot starters when the Cardinals have a lot of tired arms, need a
ball two,
need a starting pitcher. I'm sure we'll see Schieffel on the mound to start. You know, when the max season starts, when we're playing two double hitters a weekend. So
yeah. We'll have a couple of those for you.
Yes, we will. Three, maybe. If everybody likes what they're doing, we'll have 6 more games here on WCRH.
I'll tell you what, I'm having a blast. But we have all the easy stuff, I guess.
This is great. And I mean, when you got a nice day like this, I mean, you can't ask for anything better.
You really can't.
So Carlos Fernandez, the hitter.
Full count now to Carlos.
So Cabe.
6 strikeouts and 5 innings pitched. There's a ground ball, and that's actually going to go through the hole, and Michigan State's actually going to get a runner here. Bigby will corral that one out in right field and send it back into the infield.
So the final rundown for Mr. Cabe, 5 innings pitched. He gave up 1 run. It was earned. He gave up 3 hits. He did not. He walked 1 man and struck out, as you said earlier, Mr. Nelson, 6. So a good outing for Cabe. He is scheduled to get a win.
That'll bring up Mike Bassani way outside, and that's past Fitzharris. Fernandez is going to make it to second base.
So Cabe will even up his record at 2-2, barring any comeback by the Spartans. Doesn't really look that way. They're threatening for a run, but they need about 8 more threats.
That's right. Ground ball. Shane Ridley is on that one. Fires it over to first base. Bassani has retired. 1 out.
I think the Ball State fans are getting exactly what they wanted when they came out here. They heard all about this team, and this is the first chance they've had to see him. And Cardinals have not disappointed in these 3 games here at home. And just a great performance in this second game today. Nice play there by Shane.
It's routine ground ball. Did his job.
Yep.
Carlos Fernandez holds it second. Ball one. The pitch on the way. There's a fly ball into right field. It's going to go foul. Can Bigby get to it? No. One and one, the count, 1 out, runner on second base for the Spartans. Ball State leads this contest 10-1. It is early in the 6th inning. 1 more inning to go after this one, and we're done for the day. That pitch was also inside, 2-1 the count. There's another pop foul. Matt Wood might have a chance at this one. He does.
Nice play.
What a great play down there in the corner. Makes a sliding catch. And that's another quick out.
Nice play by Matt over there. Matt,
He's another great athlete on this Ball State baseball team. Kalzinski will come to the play, or come to the plate. Nice play there by Matt. I don't know if we have a replay of that or not.
Joe Kalzinski in the batter's box again with 2 outs. Adam Schiefel the pitch. Ball one.
There's the replay of Matt Wood's little play here from our center field, the shot. And you see Matt's nice little sliding
wow.
grab there. Nice shot there.
Nearly ate the fence, but he knew where it was.
Nice play by Matt. Looks good. Ooh. Looked to be right there. But Mike Walsh calls it a ball. No big deal here. 2-0 the count.
3-0. I guess Schiefel just doesn't want to get out of this inning. Strike right down the middle. He had to throw a strike there, and it's 3-1 now. I would assume that Kalzinski would be taking again, but, you know, if they want to get on the board, they're going to have to start swinging at some balls.
Yeah, they are. This, like I said, it's going to be a fun trip for them.
Like they did right there, but that's a line drive right to Jeremy Ridley, and that'll end the Michigan State Spartans' sixth inning.
We'll stay here. One hit in the inning for Michigan State, nothing across the plate. And after 6 1/2 innings of play, Ball State leads it 10-1. Gives me another opportunity to remind you, let's see, what's tonight on WCRH? Well, tonight you can catch the Burly Bear Network coming up here at 6 p.m. and followed by two movies. We're going to show The Saint at 8 o'clock tonight on WCRH, followed by at 11 p.m., Boys on the Side. So be sure to tune into that. Also another chance to remind you, don't miss Campus News 57 Monday through Thursday at 5:30 and 6 o'clock. Plus the news at noon on Tuesday and Thursday. Get all of the latest Ball State news and sports. Find out what's happening in your hometown, and you can get your exclusive Muncie five-day weather forecast. That's Campus News 57, where Ball State comes. Where Nelson first. First, I didn't even get a chance to say it. They come in first.
Ball State comes first.
Well, Ball State comes first. Definitely Ball State coming in first today.
Yes.
In this two-team horse race.
In fact, coming in first in all three games this weekend.
New pitcher for the
I'm just going to go ahead and assume that they're going to win. Now, as you know, as professional broadcasters, we have to, you know, say and be objective. However, we are students here. We pay to go to school here. We will root because we can.
Chris Yin's the new hurler for the Michigan State Spartans. He comes in with a 9.64 ERA. 9.64. He's 1-0 on the season. This is his sixth appearance. He's only seen 4 2/3 of action, 2/3 innings. He does have 2 saves, but he's not in position, just quite not in position to get a save here. For the Spartans, he's given up 7 hits, 6 runs, 5 earned, 2 walks, 8 strikeouts, and 2 doubles to be exact. Upcoming games here for Ball State. Games to be televised here on WCRH next week. Change of pace back to University Arena. We will have the Ball State men's volleyball team against Rutgers Newark as the first pitch is outside. And then the upcoming games, of course, Kent on April 3rd and Toledo on the 17th and 18th of April. And we should, if everything goes as planned.
A drive into left field from Scott French. He's going to move over. That ball's going to drop in. French is maybe going to try for second. He'll stay at first base.
And I'll finish.
And Ball State once again is on the base pass with a hit into left field from Scott French.
And like I said, Andy, we should be back on the air for possibly 6 more games this season. And, you know, if that happens, that's really going to be exciting. And it's got to be exciting to Ball State finally on TV here.
Look,
Ball State
dude, we're on TV right now.
We're on TV.
Hi, everybody.
How's everybody doing at home? How you doing, Becker? Yeah, he's doing okay. But, Ball State dominating the action today. And really hasn't been a contest here in Game 2. Game 1 was close, but Game 2, hey, what you like to see. The offense comes out and
that's right.
Scores some runs for you. Dominating performance by Covey. And,
you know, some people like pitching duels, and I like pitching duels, but I like seeing, you know, home runs and stuff like that. It makes the game more entertaining.
Sure, when
and
Rich,
heck, you know, what do you think brought Major League Baseball back? You know, the Maguire-Sosa thing last year. You know, home runs. Everybody loves the home run. And I'm glad we got to see a couple today.
Sure, when Rich Maloney joins us after the game, he will...
ground ball, possibly up the middle. Fernandez is going to take it. They're going to look for the double play, and they got it.
Six. is it 4-6-3 there?
That'd be 4-6-3, correct, if you're scoring at home.
And I'm scoring in the booth,
which has been our home for the last 12 hours.
12 hours, yeah, kind of has, hasn't it? But I've had fun. I don't know about you.
Oh, I've had a blast.
Replay.
I got the replay of the double play. Carlos Hernandez is going to scoop this one up. Do a little flip over there to Kevin Cruz, who will flip it over to Kyle Geschwin. There's another ground ball. Bigby hits another line drive down the line. It rolls foul, but it was past the base pass, so it is a fair ball. And Bigby picks up a double.
I mean, if we were gonna play 9 innings, Bigby might get another at bat. We're only playing 7, though. So.
Yep.
So Larry will not have a chance to hit for the cycle.
But he is 3-for-3, correct?
A single, a double, a home run, and he flew out in the seventh inning, or the first inning, so he's 3-of-4 from the plate.
And he does
I think he has
RBI.
Just solidified himself as our Carter's player of the game. Sorry, our condolences to Mr. Jeremy Ridley for not getting
well, Jeremy hits another. If Jeremy hits another bomb here, I'll tell you what, he's in contention.
I guess that probably would happen, wouldn't it?
That's not going to cut it.
Ooh. Jerome on the camera there, a little shaken by that one. Back to the screen. Yes, I guess I was a little premature there. I should not give out the player of the game yet. There's voting, and voting to be done up here in the booth. But I think you already knew who I'm voting for.
Well, we have to speak to all parties involved. You know, everybody gets a vote, even though there's just the two of us. Anyways, that was a foul ball.
Eric, what do you think down there? Who are you going to go for for the player of the game? You like Bigby? Like Bigby? Eric likes Bigby. Bring him up. Go ahead and talk, Eric. You've been silenced by the people that run things in the truck back there.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
There he is. Woo.
You going to go with Bigby?
Yeah, I think definitely Larry Bigby's going to be our player of the game here. Home run, double.
Now, Andy brought up an interesting point. Let's say Ridley goes yard here. What about it?
Well,
co-players of the game?
We have a little race there.
Co-players of the game?
Possibly.
We go co. How many hot dogs left for him? I remember Lindsey Fallon.
Ground ball down the
pizza.
First base side. Ridley is out after a small throw over to the pitcher, Chris Yant.
I remember Lindsey Fallon asked for a pizza after the game. Hopefully, I don't know if we have enough hot dogs left, but
we might.
Yeah. So after 6 innings of play, Ball State leads it 10-1. We'll take our last break. We'll be back. This is Ball State University Baseball.
All right, let's start it off. Hi, my name is Matt Fry of Half Baked Burly Bear, and I'm messing up all over the place, but anyways, that sort of doesn't matter, because I always mess up, and I'm giving you guys, the viewers, an opportunity to come hang with me and mess up with me on my season finale of Half Baked, and you know who's going to be doing this is Snap.com, which is like the sweetest search engine on the web, and at this address below me, this is where you got to sign in, like right here. Okay, right below me. You're gonna have to go to Snap online and register to win a chance to hang out with us. You get to come and hang with me. I don't know what we're gonna do. We're gonna like party or, you know, we're gonna have some fun. But you get to come to New York City, you check out my paddle, let you even meet my mom. You know, we're gonna have a good time. So check it out.
Kids enjoying the action here at Ball State Stadium.
Why weren't toys that cool when we were kids? Sure, we had Star Wars figures and G.I. Joe and stuff, but I mean, those things look pretty neat, and I never had that much fun with toys. But yes, back to the point at hand, we are back live at Ball Diamond. Kyle Geschwin, the first baseman, is stepping in.
Adam Schiefel to
try and close this one out.
We'll close this one out. Schiefel, nice to see him still in the game. He's going to finally get some innings after his rough outings earlier this year.
First pitch was low and away to Geschwin.
And I'm thinking that Rich Maloney is a happy man, and he will be after the ball game.
And we'll get a chance to talk to him, hopefully.
Yes, we will.
Kyle.
Not sure where yet, but Maloney will be happy to join us up in the booth, hopefully. And
swing? No swing. It was a strike anyways, though. How about 2-1?
Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule. Ball State is going to take a couple days off and then travel to Indianapolis and play
chopper
the ball.
Really high up in the air. Ridley tried to barehand it, trying to be a little showboatish maybe.
Well, when you're up 10-1, hey, anything goes. As I was saying, Ball State's upcoming schedule, they're going to take a couple days off, much deserved, and travel to Indianapolis on the 24th of March, that's this Tuesday, to play the Butler Bulldogs, who they beat twice in Evansville to open the season. And then, here it comes, they're going to travel next weekend to Wichita State, one of the best programs in collegiate baseball. They're ranked number 16, and that's pretty low from where Wichita State has been the past few years. I know they won the College World Series pretty recently. The year is not with me. And then Ball State will be back in action April 1st for the Valparaiso, that doubleheader. And then, of course, the third and fourth, hey, we're going to be right. Or actually, just the third, we'll be here live on WCRH in Channel 5 in Muncie for that doubleheader.
All right, 2-1 the count to Tom Hartley.
So Tom
runner on first and Geswin.
All right, Geswin, he singled there, apparently. Is that what happened, Mr. Nelson?
Low ball behind the backstop. No, not behind the backstop, but behind the catcher. And Geswin makes his way over to second base as
new catcher
in John Steiger. No, nope. Doug Boone, my
Doug
bad.
Doug Boone, redshirt freshman from Lanesville, Indiana, into the lineup. He saw a little bit of action yesterday, pinch hit off the Cardinals in their 10-1 victory yesterday.
I was going to make a really bad joke, but I won't know.
10-1 today.
I was going to say that technically everybody on the team is redshirted. You can beat me up after the game.
No, that's good. That's the kind of humor we're looking for. I'm sure John Shaner would one of our news anchors, John Shaner, would like that kind of humor.
John Shaner is a good news anchor, but then again, everybody we have that works with us is good too. I mean, we don't get paid for this. We just love to do it, and it's for our own experience. And I mean, it's the best opportunity ever. So if
your nose brown, mine is.
You kids in the dorms are watching this game, and you're like, hey, I want to do that. You can, you know, just come over to WCRH. It's, you know, you're always able to be on the air, you know, and maybe have your own show,
maybe your own sports show. I mean,
or yeah, exactly. Here's Gary Zego. No outs, two runners on, and first and second here early in the top of the seventh. That pitch is high.
Zego,
said that Michigan State couldn't come back, but, you know, they could muster up quite a rally here.
Now the Vegas odds are stacked against them, I believe, for this one. Actually, I bet there probably are no Vegas odds for this game. But
probably, well, I doubt it. There's Vegas odds for everything.
So yesterday's starting pitcher and today's DH all the way, Zego.
Uh-oh. That one's going to be off the bathroom, I think.
Nelson. Uh-oh. Gary Zego, you're hitless right now, buddy. Time to make a timely hit, maybe. Although, the sooner we get this one over, I think the happier everybody will be.
Not me. I'm having too much fun.
You get to do it six more times.
I know.
So
there's a drive into right field.
That one's going to be out of play.
Matt Wood's going to give it chase again just over the fence.
The Inspector Gadget arms were not there.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Zego staying alive, well, 1-2.
Yes. Zego staying alive. Eric Bastien can chime in any time. He's down there with Chris Cabay, the winning pitcher today. Go ahead.
Standing down here with starting pitcher for today's game at the end of the Ball State dugout. Chris, nice job today.
Thank you. Thanks a
lot. What were you guys able to do?
Well, I think basically getting out in front early and holding them down in the first three innings is probably our best thing we accomplished all weekend, really. Jumping out early is the main thing. We haven't been able to do that all the time, so.
Nice job picking up. Hopefully it's a three-game sweep here. This guy's tall. I'll send it up to you guys.
That he is.
Yeah, he's way taller than we could ever dream of being.
Got to be really happy with his performance today. Maybe just getting back to Ball Diamond and pitching here is what he wanted to do after that.
Just a little side note.
Disaster in
Zero struck out.
Oh, well, that's not uncommon. He's already done that once today.
Two outs away from a three-game sweep of Michigan State as Chris McQuiston steps into the booth. Booth?
He's a freshman.
We're in the booth. He's on the batter's box.
0-1 today, or in game two.
Tie it outside, ball one.
He walked in the opener as he was a pinch hitter. So Ball State, mark it down, three games here. going to move the record to 9-5 going into Butler on Tuesday. Chance to go to 10-5 there. They already took care of Butler twice. Then that Wichita State, telling you, Ball State's playing good baseball.
Right called. 2-1.
Bet Ball State would like to play Wichita State on Tuesday the way they're playing it right now.
Yeah.
But traveling out to Wichita State for two games, definitely. Ball State had a chance earlier to play some ranked teams at North Carolina State. They lost 5-2 there. And then the game in Wake Forest, which was really big because Wake Forest is a top 10 program. Good measuring stick there, even though it's early, or, you know, early on in the season. But that game was canceled due to bad weather. So the Cardinals rescheduled a game against a school by the name of High Point, scored 23 runs. So an opportunity lost there to play Wake Forest, but traveling to Wichita State to face one of the best programs in the nation, it's definitely something that Maloney's got to look forward to. We'll ask him about that.
Oh, man, that one's nothing but trouble. I'm waiting for the crashing window.
Oh, I think... Thought I heard something, but I guess too. That's not what that was.
By the way, full count here to Chris McQuiston.
There you go. Chris has walked and struck out.
Whoa, that one was real close, and he just walked again.
And the bases are, as they say, juiced.
Yes, and Don Wachowski will step in.
Sure, Rich Maloney's in the dugout saying, all right.
There will be a pinch hitter in this game. Granted, he started in the last game, as you know. Don Wachowski, pinch hitting.
Don Wachowski.
Yeah, I said it before the PA guy did.
No trouble from Don in the first game as he went 0-3, so hopefully Don can keep up his stellar performance today. And sorry, Don. I'm a Ball State fan at heart. Strike in there from Schieffel. It'll be a nice little double play to end this one, kind of fitting. Seen a few double plays today.
Swing and a miss, strike two. 1-2 the count here to Wachowski. Ground ball.
And there's our double play, man. There it is.
And that's the game, ladies and gentlemen. Ball State sweeps the Michigan State Spartans in this one in dramatic fashion as they win once again 10-1. We saw great pitching. We saw great hitting in this one. This team just showed all of their stuff in one game.
And you hear the familiar music, the celebration. It's a celebration here. Ball State wins at 10-1 just like they did Friday and sweep this doubleheader. So, Andy, the final score 10-1. I guess we'll be back maybe with our Carter's Player of the Game.
That's correct. We'll be back in just a moment. This is Ball State University Baseball.
Motion picture production. Lights. Camera. Action. Big stars and even bigger budgets. In Wilmington, North Carolina, producers are leaving Tinseltown. Find out why big-time movies are taking their shows on the road and heading to your backyard, outside Hollywood.
Thursday, March 25th, on Campus News 57.
The excitement is building for another fun-filled season under the stars at Deer Creek Music Center. Deer Creek is hiring part-time and full-time positions in the following areas: parking services, guest services, security, concessions, maintenance, and grounds. Apply in person at Deer Creek 7 days a week from March 6th through April 11th between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. Equal opportunity employer. So this season, be a part of the show.
Where you been? Come on! Come on! Where in the world would you find a top 10 teachers college? Ball State University! And where can you find one of the nation's highest student-athlete graduation rates? Ball State! Now that's higher education! And guess who has Indiana's largest undergraduate programs in theater and dance performance? Put on your dancing shoes!
Ball State University, everything you need!
Okay, looks like we are back on WCRH. Our first ever live baseball extravaganza is now over. And we're here for two big wins in the doubleheader today. The first game, Ball State won 6-3, obviously. And the last game, just most recently, within the last 5 minutes, they have won 10-1 over Michigan State. They have swept them in the three-game series.
Let's go through game one real quick first. Of course, in game one, you saw Justin Weschler pitch 5 1/3. Three hits, two runs, two earned, and he pitched 5 1/3, got his third win of the season. And the Cardinals won that one 6-3. Tim Fitzharris led the way with two hits and two runs. And we'll come back and we'll go through game two after this. But we're going to go down to Eric Bastien with our Carter's newly world-famous player of the game. And it's Larry Bigby. Go ahead and take it away with the superstar.
Thanks, guys. I'm joined on the field here by our newly world-famous player of the game, Larry Bigby. Larry, coming into the season, a lot of stuff, a lot of speculation, what's going to happen after the season. Is it nice to just come out here and play some baseball?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's hard not to think about all the awards and all that stuff and the expectations of this year. But coming into this game, all we need to do is run off some wins. And this is fortunate enough for us to win three right here. Get on a little roll. You know, I mean, we need this right here.
Good win for you. Good three-game sweep. Larry, of course, home run, double, single today. We'll be right back with Coach Maloney. We'll send it back up to you guys.
All right. Thanks, Eric. Congratulations once again to Larry Bigby. And, of course,
he just looks like a star, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
I mean, he's
and Tim Fitzharris, our other Carter's player of the game today for game one.
Yeah, let's go through real quickly game two here. 10-1, of course, as was your final. As we said, Scott French went 2-4. 2-4 and had an RBI. Tim Fitzharris with two more hits in the game, scored three runs. Right fielder Larry Bigby with the home run. And then Jeremy Ridley also had a home run. Bigby with three hits, Ridley with two. Both guys had three RBIs and both scored two runs. John Kesick had a hit and two RBIs. Shad Turner did not get a hit, and I don't think he had a hit all day. He had one hit in game one, so Shad. Matt Wood got his only hit of the day. Matt did have two RBIs in game one, nothing in game two. Shane Ridley, who went 2-4 in game one, went 0-3. Eric Bava and Aaron Zanel shared the outfield positions there. Nate Brown also came in. And Chris Cabe, really the story. Five innings pitched, two hits, one run, one earned, one walk, and six of those strikeouts. And Andy, after what Cabe did last Tuesday in Terre Haute, coming out today and getting that kind of a performance in five innings, Rich Maloney's got to be happy. Chris Cabe's got to be happy, and I think everybody involved with Ball State baseball's got
to
be happy.
Well, I'm just happy that we got to do what we got to do today. But, yes, the team should be happy. You know, they had a great road trip in North Carolina. They kind of struggled against Indiana State, and then they've come home, and they've really kind of solidified. You know, this will send them on the good road trip with these three wins under your belt, you know, against a Big Ten team like a Michigan State. It's only an uphill, you know, it's only a bigger, you know, thing from
yeah,
here.
We've got
I can't think of the cliche I'm trying to say.
We've got bigger fish to fry next week, of course, when we'll play Wichita State. And, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what Ball State does next week, you know, if they can take from these three games here and just go on and just play solid baseball. I think Eric Bastien's down on the field with Coach Maloney. Take it away, Eric. You got to have a happy coach right there.
I think I do have a happy coach, guys. Three-game series, big three-game set for you. Big Ten team coming in. You guys got the job done.
Yeah, we sure did, Eric. That was a personal goal of ours, is to win against Big Ten teams. The conference is recognized, and it's a great baseball conference. And fortunately, we played extremely well this weekend, and we were able to get the job done. So I'm extremely pleased.
You guys were hitting the ball today. Yesterday, 17 hits yesterday. Looks like 11 today. Got to be pleased with your hitters, too.
Yeah, we've got a good hitting ball club, 1-9. And what I'm extremely pleased about is I thought we pitched a lot better this whole weekend. And that's very important for us as we continue our quest to win as many games as we can and to repeat as regular season MAC champions. That's what we want to do. So we have to shore down the pitching, and it's certainly today we took a big step forward.
You guys got the job done. Thanks, Coach. Good luck next weekend at Wichita State, and we'll be back here for Kent right on WCRH. We'll send it back up to you guys.
All right. Thanks, Eric.
Make sure you tell the coach thanks for, you know, cooperating with us and making this thing really, you know, fun for us and stuff, too.
Hopefully we've started a nice little relationship here. I think right now we're going to take another two-minute break. We're going to come back. We'll have our Carters play the game. We will go over some final statistics and talk about, once again, we'll tell you when our next game's here on WCRH. So after this break, we'll come back to some final statistics. You just watched Ball State University Baseball. We thank you for watching, and stay tuned for more postgame.
When something happens, Campus News 57 is there.
Sunday morning, approximately around 7 a.m., a fire broke out in the officers' room located on the second floor. We really need blood donors, and we want more people to sign up for the National Marrow Donor Program, too.
Housing residents' life may have to house some students in study lounges, and some RAs may have roommates.
Campus News 57, where Ball State comes first.
Your friend has been drinking vodka and cranberry juice for the past 3 hours. She's passed out on the couch now, and you can't wake her up. She feels clammy, and her breathing is shallow. You want to call the hospital, but you don't want to get her into trouble. Besides, you can't overdose on alcohol, can you? If someone has exceeded the limits, call for emergency assistance immediately.
All right, let's start it off. Hi, my name is Matt Fry, of Half-Baked Burly Bear, and I'm messing up all over the place. But anyways, that sort of doesn't matter, because I always mess up. And I'm giving you guys, the viewers, an opportunity to come hang with me and mess up with me on my season finale of Half-Baked. And you know who's going to be doing this is Snap.com, which is like the sweetest search engine on the web. And at this address below me, this is where you got to sign in, like right here, okay, right below me. You're gonna have to go to Snap online and register to win a chance to hang out with us. You get to come and hang with me. I don't know what we're going to do. We're going to, like, party or, you know, we're going to have some fun. But you get to come to New York City. You check out my paddle. I'll let you even meet my mom. You know, we're going to have a good time. So check it out.
Back at some of the big moments from this game this afternoon, or games, plural.
There you see Randy Ferris cleaning things up. It was Ball State clean house this weekend. A three-game sweep of Michigan State, a Big Ten opponent, as Coach Maloney said, and that was the goal of the team this weekend was to take this series, and they did that. They did a great job of that. And I think the thing that we got right now is everything is working for Ball State.
Yes, definitely.
And
it's good to just lead in, you know, like we were saying, into the Wichita State next weekend with, you know, a bunch of really strong wins under your belt. We're not going to do the highlights. We're going to go ahead and maybe do the Carters play of the game. Do we have that?
Probably going to be Larry Bigby's home run. I'll go ahead and say that Michigan State had one run on four hits in today. In game two today, they committed one error. Ball State, 10 runs, 11 hits, and no errors. Home runs by Larry Bigby, his fifth, and Jeremy Ridley, his fifth. So the two big guns, the three and four slot, the hitters there, you know, matched each other today with home runs. And Bigby also with a double, his fourth. Jeremy Ridley, his fifth double of the year, and Matt Wood chipped in with a double. Great performance today. The only thing that Ball State seemed to fail at doing today was stealing bases today.
Yeah, nobody stole a base the whole game. Both teams had, you know, catchers with rocket arms. They could just get that ball out of their hands so quick into second base, and every throw was right on the money, and these guys were sliding into gloves, holding the ball, just sliding out, you know?
Yeah, it was a great game for the Cardinals. Great series yesterday. Of course, they won 10-1 and capped off game two 10-1. The close one was 6-3.
We'll go back and talk more a little bit about that one too. Weschler with the 5 1/3, great performance by him. And then game two, Cabay with the five innings there. Great performance from the starting pitchers, and then the relievers came in. Schiefel, a little bit of trouble, but he didn't give up any runs.
No.
So, I mean, a great performance by them right there. And only thing I know to say right now is we're going to be back in 2 weeks. Actually, we'll be at the University Arena on next Saturday evening for Ball State Men's Volleyball. You can catch that live on Channel 5 here in Muncie. And in 2 weeks, then we will be back here, hopefully, for the Akron Zips, and that will open up the MAC season.
That's right.
I think I misstated that. Will be the Kent Golden Flashes. Right. Akron will be on Sunday,
and then the 17th and 18th, we will be hosting the Toledo Rockets.
Rockets from the MAC. So, the MAC right now, the Ball State looks like the class of the MAC. So we'll see what happens when MAC play comes around. But Butler and Wichita State to come up in the schedule for Ball State now.
Okay, well, we're having trouble with finding the Bigby home run. Maybe we'll get to that. Maybe we won't. You'll see it again, because we know you guys all taped this anyways. Because it's the first live baseball game event ever. I would tape it. Hey, I'm in the thing.
We'll go ahead this opportunity to tell you what's up tonight on WCRH. We're gonna see the Burly Bear Network coming up here at 6 p.m. And then the movie The Saint at 8 p.m. starring who's in that movie? Val Kilmer
and Elizabeth Shue.
And then at 11 p.m. tonight on WCRH, you will have Boys on the Side. So a couple movies here tonight on WCRH, and, of course, catch the news throughout the week. We just want to go ahead and thank our crew.
Yeah, I just want to go ahead and say that, you know, this has been one of the, you know, most fun times I've had. This has been a boyhood dream of mine to call a baseball game on television, and I couldn't have done it without the help of all the WCRH people who, you know, came out with us, and were out here early in the morning, some of us earlier than others. And I want to thank the people from WIPB, too, who helped us get this whole thing set up. None of us know how to do this, especially Bill Bryant, Chris Reedy, Paul Nijak, Dottie Krebs, Joe Krubin, Del Feltz. I know I might be forgetting somebody else, and I'm sorry. I will thank you in person. And I'd also like to thank our faculty advisor, Tim Pollard, who got this whole thing in motion and just came up to Jeff and I and said, hey, let's do this. And it was just kind of an idea then, and now we have proof that we've actually done it, and it's been great. That's all I got.
Oh, I got one more thanks. Thanks to Carter's Nearly World Famous
yes,
Hot
definitely.
Dogs for sponsoring us today and catering us with a nice little lunch. We all love hot dogs, and Carter's Nearly World Famous play and players of the game, at least. We're going to have the play of the game. But, great to see Ball State get 3 wins under the belt this weekend. You saw 2 of them right here on WCRH. You have a chance to see maybe 6 more. So it'll be exciting to come back here in 2 weeks and see where Ball State's at.
Yeah.
So we thank you for joining us, Andy.
Yeah, I think that you guys, hold on. They I think we have something to run for them. Is that correct, Chris? Okay, what is that?
All right. Maybe it's the play of the game.
Okay, we did find the home run for you. We're going to run it for you. And whenever you guys are ready to go, here it is.
Your Carter's Nearly World Famous play of the game, Larry Bigby, deep to right field.
Actually, that's Matt Wood.
That'd be Matt Wood.
That was the huge bomb that he hit off the wall. To get the double.
Yes,
same distance
double.
Pretty much.
Okay, so Matt Wood's double is going to be our Carter's Nearly World Famous play of the game.
That's fine with me.
Our apologies to Larry Bigby. Hopefully that ball is still traveling somewhere towards Indianapolis.
Yep.
But
maybe it might be in Ohio by now. Remember, that's east, so we don't know. But thanks once again for joining us. It's been fun, and we'll see you next time. Don't forget to watch the news on Monday. This has been it from Ball Diamond. For Jeff Mullins, I'm Andy Nelson. We just did the first live baseball game in Ball State history. You're pretty excited about that.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We'll see you next time.
See you next week for Men's Volleyball.